the two major parties today are the Democrats and the Republicans. But how we got here is a bit complex.
If you go back to the founding of our country, the two main groups at the time were Federalists,
who were advocated for a strong constitution and a stronger federal government, while the Anti-Federalists,
more in favor of a strong state government.
So once the Constitution was ratified, the Bill of Rights was passed, then the parties started to change. The Anti-Federalists became the Democratic Republicans. The Federalists stuck around for a few more years and eventually became the Whig Party.
In the mid-1800s, slavery expansion became a major issue.
In the Whig Party, you had a real division over this. So anti-slavery Whigs went on to become the Republican Party.
At the time, the Republican Party was gaining popularity in the North while the Democratic Party was popular in the South.
The Democratic Party was having its issues too.
Southern Democrats were in favor of an expansion to slavery, while Northern Democrats felt that new states should make their own decision.
That disagreement allowed Lincoln and the Republican Party to take the election in 1860.
The Republican Party became synonymous for social justice, eventually passing the 13th, 14th, and 15th Amendment.
In the 1920s, the Republican Party primarily just represented big business and wealth.
Democrats, by contrast, were considered the less wealthy party and were supported by white, ethnic, working class immigrants and by farmers in rural areas.
Then, 1929. The Great Depression happened and pretty much everybody blamed the Republicans.
The economy was devastated, and that devastation allowed Franklin Delano Roosevelt, a Democrat, to come to power in 1932 with his program, the New Deal.
The New Deal was FDR's plan to help Americans get out of the Great Depression.
The New Deal is really the era when the Democratic Party begins to look a little more like what it is today. It starts to be the voice of working class voters, and for the first time since the Civil War, African Americans began to move away from the Republicans, the party of Lincoln.
Throughout the 1950s and 1960s, the Democrats continued to be associated with big government. The Democrats passed some big deal legislation around civil rights, the Civil Rights Act of 1964 and the Voting Rights Act of 1965.
Republicans, by contrast, presented themselves as champions of white voters and of small government to make America better. The changes in the political culture of the 1960s and 70s really laid the groundwork for where we are today. And that past isn't simple, or at least it's more complicated than the hot takes you might get on Twitter.